Hi folks, welcome back. I'm finally, after getting sidetracked with a couple of vinyl tags, I'm getting round to doing the Pete's Picks video that I've been meaning to do for a while. That's where I show some of the new items in my collection or stuff that's been on the turntable. Let's go on. There's a few to show. First three are going to be Norwegian prog. So I'm not going to say too much about them. I'm just going to point you in the direction of that employee of the Norwegian Arts Council, Richard, the vinyl progger, who's shown these albums, I think, and described them far better than I could. And being Norwegian himself, you get the correct pronunciation where I. Which is what I can't do. Right, first off is the latest album by Jorge. And I think this is about their fourth or fifth album. Just come out, and it's Pastoralia. This is superb, you could say 70s based prog. They're basically a duo, but with guest musicians. On first listen, this sounds more varied than the ones I'd heard before. On the opening track, Prologue, it sounds very Canterbury-ish. You get, as with a lot of Scandinavian prog bands, you get some folk stylings along the way, Scandinavian folk. And you also, I think, with particularly with the title track and one of the others, you get a bit of that RIO sort of chamber rockish sort of vibe. But this is an excellent album. Like I say, check out Richard's channel where he describes this in more detail. Well worth having for any prog fan. Next up is another one that Richard showed just recently. And that's Tusmørke and their album Nordisk Crime, or I think it stands for Nordic Crime. This is a concept album, I think, based on the finding of some bodies in some Danish bogs, which turned out, I think, to be hundreds, if not thousands of years old. They're an excellent band, Tusmørke. I first came across them when Svart, the Finnish label, was selling off very cheaply the three of their albums. Picked those up, really loved them. They incorporate, again, a lot of folk stylings in their music, though I think on this one they seem to have toned that down a little bit. But well worth checking out. That's Tusmørke. And finally, with the Norwegian prog, I can't remember if Richard shown this one, but this is Arabs in Aspic with, I think, their sixth studio album. And it's called Madness and Magic. Again, they're in that very much in that sort of 70s prog vein, lots of Hammond organ. They've got two percussionists, a drummer and a percussionist proper. They're probably a bit heavier than the other bands, but excellent with it. Excuse me. So check them out. So that isn't the end of Norway for the, but we'll get back to Norway later on.
Thank you. the victims wept beneath the weight of sacrifice. Bitter tears, sweet nectar for the buzzing flies. Truth hid by legend, fed by lies. Simple facts enhanced by chants and cries.
Worlds of bullet mixed with blood. Garlands of spring flowers caked with mud.
As the congregation stares to God, gathered round these gaping wounds inside the holy ball.
I think in his last video, the legend that is Mr. Rob Bison showed the latest album by Matt Berry and spoke very highly of it. Now, I know of Matt Berry as a comedian, but though I've never really watched any of his stuff. But I knew he was a big name in the music field. I didn't realise he'd been going so long though. His first album was recorded, I think, back in 2000. Though it's, I think, from about 10 years ago that he's heavily been recording. I've never checked him out though. Read so much good stuff about him in magazines that I read, but never checked him out. So after seeing Rob's video, I thought, I'll go and check on YouTube. And I liked what I heard, I really did. Excellent stuff. He covers a various styles. A couple of the earlier ones, I think, was it Witch Hazel and Kill the Wolf, are very much in a prog folk vein. I really wanted to try and find those. But not only can you not get the vinyl, you can get the CDs, but you've got to be willing to pay about 60 odd quid for a copy of Witch Hazel and around 130 quid for a copy of Kill the Wolf. Don't understand that. He's got a good name for himself at the moment. Why is his stuff not available? Anyway, he's also done an album of TV themes, and he's done an electronica album. But this is his album from last year that I bought, Phantom Birds. And this is his sort of singer-songwriter with country inflections album. He says he was influenced by sort of Nashville Skyline era Dylan. And this is an excellent album, really is. He plays all the instruments himself with the exception of the drums, which are played by Craig Blundell, and on here he also has the great BJ Cole on pedal steel guitar. I don't think there's been a country rock album released in this country that hasn't featured BJ Cole since the 70s. But no, this is superb. I've since then ordered his latest, which I think is in a psych pop vein. From what I've heard, that's great as well. I'd love to try and pick up some more, but I wish I hadn't left it so late. Excellent stuff.
You said John, I asked how high. Cool hit jets, just something in my eyes.
Next, and this is a theme with a lot of these early ones, another recommendation, if you like, from the VC, and this is Sonar with their album Black Light. This was shown by Mr. Dawson, Michael P. Dawson, in his vinyl, prog vinyl tag. And these are a Swiss four-piece, often described as sort of math rock or post-rock, very much in that sort of, in a minimalist style. So I always think of math rock as being far busier, but this is instrumental, excellent stuff. They've done a number of albums, I think, with David Torn, the famous guitarist. But well worth checking out. Carrying on, and again, this comes from, well, to a degree from a video, this time done by Alan the Static Traveller. He showed two albums in one of his random pulls from his record collection. There was the two albums done by Jean-Baptiste Barrière under the Pandemonium name. This one is the second one, Non Jamais L'Espérance. I had the first one, I've had that for 30 odd years, I think, since it came out, and it is brilliant. So I decided, never saw this one before, had a look on Discogs, somebody was selling it for a decent price, so I went for it. These two albums are absolutely incredible. They're avant-garde electronics, quite bleak and scary in places, but superb. It's on the Artem label. If you haven't heard these, I'll put a needle drop with some of these and hopefully you'll enjoy this, but I can't recommend these highly enough. To Norway. A few years back, oh God, it must be going around 10 years or more, a friend and I went to Oslo for a long weekend, and we decided to try and take in a gig while we're there, and we went to this basement venue, which is jam-packed, and there was a superb band on there. And they were this band, Los Plantronics. This is their album, Organic Voodoo Soup. Now, they are a mariachi, surf rock, garage rock band. On the day that we saw them, I think it must have been in May, because they seem to be celebrating Cinco de Mayo, the Mexican Day of the Dead. The band were all done out in their mariachi costumes. They had a horn section with them, with the exception of the drummer, who plays standing up and wears a Mexican wrestling mask. they were superb. It's one of the most fun gigs I've ever seen. They played sort of spaghetti western music, Ennio Morricone style, Good, Bad and the Ugly and all of that sort of stuff. They played a number by The Clash, some garage rock stuff, some of their own. So much fun. So I decided, never owned any of their stuff on any medium. I saw this going cheap on Discogs, so I had to have it. On here they do their version of Devil with a Blue Dress, and they do the Birds Artificial Energy as well. Excellent band, great fun. Not what you'd expect to find it, Norwegians doing mariachi surf rock. There you go. Band I've known since the 90s, and I've got three or four CDs by, but this is the only album that I think that they ever did on vinyl, and this is the Morrigon with their album Rides Out. This is actually an autographed copy. I don't know if you can see the autographs on there. The Morrigon were around in the 90s. I think this album was from 1990. I think this might be their first. And they were a electric folk band, prog folk band, absolutely great band. They do versions of, what do they do on here, Corpus Christi, Tom of Bedlam, you know, The Rakes of Kildare. Excellent band, highly recommended to anybody who's into electric folk rock. There weren't many bands, I think, in the 90s doing this style of music. They were one of the best. Next up, we go to India. Well, not quite. This is an album, The Encyclopedia of Civilizations, Volume 3, India. Now, this is a series of albums, well, three at least, where they look at ancient, they get musicians to interpret or to musically visualize ancient civilizations. I think the first one was to do with Atlantis, the second with Egypt, and this one with India. On each album, they're split albums, are two artists, both from the same country as well. I think the first, the Atlantis one, was two American artists. The Egypt one was two artists from Belgium, one being, I think, Bichin Bahajars. And this one is two French artists, Jonathan Fitoussi, who I didn't know, and Ariel Kalmer, who I'd heard of. Let me just show you, and it's on the Abstrace album, and it comes with, excuse me, a booklet describing the concept behind it and the tracks. Now, I haven't described the music, have I? This is, well, let's take them one at a time. The Jonathan Fitoussi reminds me very much of the music of sort of like Peter Michael Hamill, the who was the leader of the German band Between. It's that sort of electronic organ music, minimalist in style, but superb. I'm going to have to look up this, see if this guy's done any more. Ariel Kalmer is, like I say, again, a French musician. This one, his side is two tracks, Yin Yang and Flute Meditation, which reminds me very much of the German artist Deuter, who I showed in my Krautrock series. More new age-ish than the Jonathan Fitoussi, but very good, beautiful music. I'd like to get the other two albums in this series if they're available. With the electronic theme, but going to the other end of the world, this is Cybertron and their album Colossus. Now, Cybertron were an Australian trio, a drummer and two keyboardists, very much in that sort of Berlin School German Kosmische Musik vein. I've got one other album by them, which is a live album. This is a reissue on the Dual Planet label from last year. I can't remember when this was originally released. Comes in a nice coloured vinyl. But if you're a Tangerine Dream fan, you're going to, I think, really enjoyed this one. Check them out. I think all of Dual Planet have probably reissued most of their albums. I think they only did three or four, to be honest. Excellent stuff. Home country, the old home country, which, congratulations by the way to Italia for winning the Eurovision Song Contest, not so much for winning it, but for winning it with a really good hard rock song, which I don't know how they managed to get that into the contest given the absolute tripe that the rest of the contest was made up of, but was glad to see them win it. So this is a modern prog band called La Coscienza di Zeno, The Conscience of Zeno, with their album Un Vita Migliore, which means a better life. I'd never heard of these before, but I saw it in an online sale and I had a listen and it was really good. They're in that typical Italian prog vein, that sort of romantic prog of people like Banco, etc. I think originally they started off more of a UK prog based prog style band, you know, the usual suspect like Yes, but moved more into PFM and the Banco vein. This is excellent, particularly the title track, and I really love, there's a track called Danza Ferma, which is very Baroque in nature and reminds me of Leorme's Florian album, if you've ever heard that, which was totally atypical for Leorme. Very Baroque, you know, but well worth, again, well worth checking out if you're into Italian prog. I'll definitely be looking out for some of their other albums. With just going to show two more, just to prove miracles can happen. I keep on saying that I never find anything at my local charity shop. We've only got one in the town. It's always got the same Max Bygraves and battered classical albums. I went in when they were allowed to open up again, and it was the same set of albums, I think, that had been there for 2 years. But while I was in there checking out the books, I just caught something out, somebody asking for a bag of records, and they brought them out from the bag, and he toddled off. I didn't have time to ask then, but next time I was in, I thought, I'll ask if they get any new stuff, any new records in. And she says, oh yeah, we've got some in the back. Do you want to see them? So, of course. my heart dropped when I first saw them, I must admit. In fact, the first two or three were albums I'd put in about 2 years ago. after that, it was the usual crap. But right at the bottom were two albums. I thought, I'm having those. Didn't even look at to see the condition for it. I thought, for a quid, I will have a go. And the first of these was John Lennon, Yoko Ono's Milk and Honey. Now this was, I think, meant to be the follow-up to their album Double Fantasy, which I have to be honest, I have never heard. It takes the same format, so I think, as a Double Fantasy, song by John, song by Yoko, song by John, etc. The tracks that John wrote were worked on before his assassination. I think Yoko's tracks were worked on about a year or so later. It's not a bad album, actually. I quite enjoyed this. I think John's tracks are a little bit stronger than Yoko's. And I think that's partly, well, for me, because they're a bit rougher in nature. They're not polished. Obviously, if he'd lived longer, he would have worked on these, and they would have had a, you know, that more produced feel to them. But not bad at all. Well worth keeping for a quid, I think. And the other one is one I've been looking for, excuse me, for quite a while and never seen. So I was really pleased to find this. And this is Queen's double live album, Live Killers. This is probably where, as far as I go with Queen, I love the early stuff and I like the albums up to and including jazz. And I think this came out just after jazz. After that point, I was never really keen on most of their material. This is when they were still basically a rock band. But I've been looking for this one for a long time. For some reason, never see it in the wild. So when I found it, I was so pleased. The cover needed a good clean. It was like plaster or whatever stuck on it. And with both of them, the vinyl needed a really good clean, but they both play excellently. So really pleased to find that one. So that's it. That's my set of recent finds. There's more, but I'll leave those for another time. Tomorrow's the Kendall Record Fair. I'll be going off in the morning, hopefully finding lots of goodies. So I hope you're all doing well. Hope you have a great weekend. And I will see you soon.
Ma sono fuori di testa, ma diversa da loro. E tu sei fuori di testa, ma diversa da loro.